Do you ever look at yourself one day and think you are hot as shit, but the next day comes and you become Quasimodo? Why do you think this happens? IDK why it happens, but I agree that it does. Well, if that isn't cased closed, I don't know what is. I think sometimes moods change. Some days you're Jay, would you fuck me? I'd fuck me so hard. And other days you just wake up and you're not your type that day. Which is okay, right after a haircut, and I've actually paid attention to what I'm wearing. I'll never interact with another human pumping gas at 8 a.m. unshow it, and in sweatpants? Half of high school alumni pull up. Yeah, but if you pump gas in your sweats at 8 a.m. unshowered once a week but only get your hair cut once every 6 months, that's to be expected. I'm around myself a lot as a female who routinely puts on makeup and plucks my eyebrows and is really close up to my face a lot, and also always doing my hair. So I think I'm pretty familiar with myself and the changes that occur on a day-to-day basis. Your appearance does change, and it depends on a lot of factors. Like how much sleep you got the past couple of nights, how my skin is doing, affected by allergens, diet, weather, etc. And my how hair looks, one day super puffed and won't settle in the right way, other days somehow doing exactly what I want it to, etc. So one day I could be extremely tired, so I have darker bags under my eyes, and I've been around one too many cats, so my face is red in some spots, the weather has been dry, so my skin is lacking that hydration glow, and my hair just won't sit right and isn't doing anything for the shape or dimensions of my head and face, so I'll feel ugly and hate life. Other days I wake up fresh skin, fresh nice moisture level making the texture and glow just right, my eyes are bright with no bags or sags, and my hair is settling in a way that complements my features just right, and I'm like hot damn, I'd fuck me. Put my contacts in, yep. Always think I look pretty after doing my hair and putting makeup on. Then glasses, and boom, no longer look pretty. That's so you can have a rom-com style glow up. Haha, look at that ugly ass loser with the glasses. Girl takes off glasses. Whoa, she's beautiful. PSU, but she still has paint on her overalls. For what it's worth, most people don't notice the smaller details, but we do because we know our own faces very well. You need to actively think to see someone else's smaller acne, but to yourself your acne are the first thing someone sees, because it's out of place or a flaw you're aware of. I think it also depends on lighting. Under some lights you may look nice, but others maybe not. Till I need to stay in the dark. You know when you're jacking off to porn and the porn is absolutely amazing, and then you come and are disgusted by the porn you're watching? Every time, that's when you're supposed to make the important decisions. That's definitely when you don't make important decisions. Should I apply for that job? Hell no. Why would they want to hire a disgusting pervert like me? Wait a couple of hours till the shame dies down. But you're not just making decisions with your cock. That's the sweet spot. Yeah, bitch. Do you like that? Very quickly followed by Jesus. Look how he is treating this woman. Women-friendly porn exists, support that industry. I found some good stuff like that on Pornhub, and now all the recommendations think I'm a woman. Like, really, only women watch the ones where they're not getting fucked until they're crying. Cause I can't stand that shit, and I'm just a normal straight guy. Worse is when you catch your reflection in it. I don't need a reminder of how fucking ugly I am when I'm jacking off. Believe me, I know, and that is Black Mirror, we know. OMG, I thought I was the only one. As a gay man who watches gay and hetero porn, I felt disgusted after watching gay porn and made me question my own sexuality. But now that I see, I think it may be normal. After coming you feel disgusted, it might be due to addiction or chronic use of porn. When you watch porn for many years you start to get desensitized and escalate to more exotic content to get the dopamine high you're looking for. Check the effects of porn on the brain. It's a fucking drug. I remember as a kid in the 90s, catching a glimpse of it in an R-rated movie would make my entire week. Wish I could erase every memory of the female body from my brain and then go to Pornhub. I look great in my mirror when getting ready to go out. Then I show up in pictures looking like crap. Lol. I call it my magic mirror. I noticed when I moved into another rental house that I looked really weird in the bathroom mirror. It made me look pale and overall just not as attractive. I've lived here a year now and I always feel like I look good in it. I think this magic mirror thing is because we become accustomed to consistently seeing ourselves and thus perceiving ourselves as the image in the mirror we use almost every day. So when we see ourselves in a different lighting and area, we feel like we look weird because we're not used to that version of us. Just try and remember that others do not view our imperfections as harshly as we do. Also keep in mind we're not symmetrical. So when you look in a mirror, you're looking at a mirror image of your face. Front-facing cameras do the same thing. But when you see yourself in a photo, you're looking at what you look like to the rest of the world. It's not unlike hearing your voice through a recording. It doesn't sound quite right, so you feel uncomfortable. When you look at a photo, you look slightly different than what you're used to seeing, your mirror image. Same. You always look great in your mirror at home, and then when you see yourself in a picture mirror at school or work, you look horrendous. I've read that this happens because you are comfortable with your reflected view of yourself. When you see your face in a picture, as your face is asymmetrical, you look funny to you, as with your head voice vs your recorded voice. I think it's based off mood. Like if I had a great day and life is just bending over for me, then yeah, I look like Zeus on his 18th birthday. But when life bends me over, goddamn, I look like Frankenstein's monster's pet dog. So I think it's just mood. Frankenweenie. Okay, this is a little unrelated, but when I was like 6 or something, I saw a trailer for that movie, and I got so scared that I cried and hyperventilated for like 4 hours or mayo. Edit, I was def way older than 6 if it came out in 2012, so it was just a huge pussy about dead stuff or something. Quantity of water vs alcohol I've had. Well, hydrated and sober looks a lot better. You sound just like my goddamn mom. Drink your water, UL Pobster. Maybe refrain your alcohol consumption, UL Pobster. We all think you might have a serious problem, and we're worried about you. Gets super annoying. That's when you just ignore that hater and slam back another 40 AM I write my peoples. 100% sure I angered a very petty woolock at some point in my youth or adolescence. It'd explain a lot, really. Ovulation. Was just going to post this. Ovulation makes me gorgeous. 2 days later and I'm a troll again. It's natural entrapment. Lol at natural entrapment. This is what I've noticed also. Around ovulation, women will tend to think, damn, I look really good today. It has to do with estrogen being at its highest and a small testosterone surge. It's nature's way for fertile women to attract a mate. Never thought of this, but it makes sense. Semi-related, but I cannot figure out for the life of me why I'm always at my horniest during my period. I feel like that's not how it's supposed to work. Sorry if that's TMI. I know I'm a handsome man from the front, but have a weird head shape from the side. So I avoid turning my head at all times. So like if you're at a party where there's a girl you like, you're just like an owl all night making sure she doesn't see the side of your head. Try to keep eye contact. Either it will work and you will get her attention, or she will label you a creep. No in between. It's all about confidence. If you're feeling good, then you'll think you look good. I don't think it's just confidence. Sometimes I wonder if it's diet, the amount of sleep I've had, hormone fluctuations, water retention, and or dehydration. But then also probably some psychology could be involved. Posture plays a big part in it. If you wake up feeling really good, your posture is going to reflect that, and everything about your body gets a little boost with that. If you wake up feeling gross, your posture is worse, and you end up more scrunched up, which looks less attractive. Confidence plays a role too, but if you wake up and you think you're looking worse than usual, try fixing up your posture. Any tips on unscrunching? Roll your shoulders backwards, opening your chest up. Do this for a bit and loosen up. Then put your arms out by your sides, palms facing forward, and roll your shoulders up and back, and try to find that spot where your shoulders seem to rest on your back. Let them sit in that spot and hold this position for a minute or so and take deep breaths. Your chest may feel tight when you breathe, but the more you do this the better it will be. I hope this makes sense. I've been doing this for about 30 seconds to 1 minute every few hours, and I've noticed a huge improvement with my posture and neck back pain. That neck and back pain is often from looking down at your phone or computer for long periods or just any work where you are scrunching forward. It's becoming a very common issue for many people.